And welcome to Political Notebook when Wendy Schiller comes in and talks about the three hot topics of the week. Thanks for coming in as always. We're going to have ex-president Bill Clinton coming in to endorse a candidate who's running against the guy he endorsed last time.
It's a big switcheroo, right? I mean, he's changing sides. He's coming to support Seth Magaziner. And I think that this is an interesting debate. What does Frank Caprio do? You know, how do you handle this? You have to be respectful. The president's coming to town. But, you know, sort of being abandoned by Clinton can't be fun. And I don't know how much of a boost it will give Magaziner, but it certainly, I don't think at this point, hurt him among Democratic voters.
Yeah, it'll bring a lot of attention, at least to that race. And that takes us to our next topic, which is the down ballot races, which haven't been getting a lot of attention.
No, and there's a lot of contestation, right? Secretary of State, Democratic Party, you know, you've got some real contests going on.
Right.
And we're not paying enough attention because we've got so much other things to think about with the governor's primaries and the mayor's race. So these are really important positions also in Rhode Island. So voters have to figure out a way. How do we get information? There aren't a lot of TV ads. We're not seeing a lot of information here.
Right.
And that's going to be a disadvantage going into the primary, not knowing who to pick.
It's funny that the Providence mayor's race is overshadowing some of these statewide contests.
Yeah, in a big way, because it's getting a lot of national attention as well as local attention. And it's tied in, I think, to the governor's race.
But that comes to our next topic. We're talking about big money. And even the province mayor's race, they're spending a lot of money. So Rhode Island is no longer a little backwater when it comes
to
political
spending. Not at all. We're going towards a record in the governor's race, millions of dollars raised and spent by the Democratic candidates, at the very least.
Yep.
And then in the mayor's race, you know, Buddy Cianci's raising money, you know, and other people are raising money to keep him out of the race, and Solomon's lending himself money, hundreds of thousands of dollars. So these are really contested elections with big money, and we haven't seen that kind of politics in this wide a range before.
And in such a single media market environment, it's hard to spend all that money, I would think. At least you can't spend it all on TV ads. There aren't enough TV stations to go around.
No, but I think ground game is essential, particularly for both the Republican and the Democratic governor's primaries, and also the mayor's race. I think ground game is super important. How many of those people watching those ads are registered to vote and will get out on election day and vote for you? That's the kind of information that costs money, and mobilization costs money, and we'll see how the campaigns do at spending and budgeting their money that way.
Very good. Well, there's Political Notebook.